Hey English learners, welcome to another edition of Learning Simplified Pro. It's good to see you back again. Now in this video, we would be talking about the difference between some of the English words. So let's get started. Now most of us are confused as to where to use that and which. So I would be telling you the difference between these two with the suitable sentences. Now talking about that and which in particular, that is used to indicate a particular object, item, person, situation, etc. wherein which is used to add information to the objects, items, persons, situations, etc. Now talking about the sentences for that, she was driving a van that had an Indian plate. So here I'm indicating that the van had an Indian plate, wherein for the which the example is they got into the van which had an Indian plate. So here I'm giving an information that the van had an Indian plate. Now going to the next set of the confusing words are the words for and since. Now understanding their difference is really important. For we use it for a length of time, wherein for since it's a point in the time. Now for example, for 5 years, for an hour, for a long time. Wherein for since, it's since 10 a.m., since January, since 1981. So some of the examples are, she waited at the station for 2 hours. So I'm giving you the length of time here, 2 hours. But for since, she is working since 7 a.m. So here I'm mentioning a point in the time. Now the next set is the difference between maybe and maybe. You can understand the difference in which the both of them are being written. Now let's quickly understand the difference between both of them. For maybe, may is a modal verb which indicates possibility. And for maybe, maybe is an adverb which means perhaps. So one is a verb and one is an adverb. So always remember that maybe means possibly and maybe means perhaps. So example is, she may be late. So it's possible that she can be late. And another example is for maybe as adverb, maybe it will stop raining soon. So I can even say that perhaps it will stop raining soon because I'm not sure. Now I hope with this presentation the idea about the confusing words is clear to you to some extent. But if you want more clarity, you have to start using it in your day-to-day language. Only then, you know, you can actually understand the difference between both of them. So thank you for being with me on this presentation.